show you the table, the quotes about the big storm, historical storm, which is going to happen today, tomorrow, in the state. So let us really see the headlines really all over today in the internet. And clearly, New York City mayor said, so what he says, that this could be a storm likes of which we have never seen before. And Boston is expected to get 18 to 24 inches of snow, and Philadelphia 4 to 16 inches. So no doubt all of the causes is written on top of this headline, panic, virus, flood grocery stores, and commuters are begged to stay home ahead of historic blizzards that threaten to drop 3 feet of snow in New York City and up to 57 million on East Coast. So, no doubt, it's something which, as he said, almost never appeared. So, we know quite well, our rabbis tell us really the Torah and the Talmud, that things like this which are happening are precede the time of Messiah. Whether it is earthquake and all kinds of floods and tsunamis and so on, this is also one of them. And as we are now in a year, which is a sabbatical year, and next year the year after, which is Super Mashiach. So no doubt that important message in this event, especially as the prophet Zephaniah, if you put the prophet Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 8, 9, really, clearly says that such disaster will take place with the intention that Israel people will learn from it, will take more Musar, Al-Tichim Musar. Unfortunately, the next verse says that they keep on living in their wrong ways, and then a clear description of the war of Gog and Magog, 26 words in Hebrew, and all the 27 letters of the alphabet, which is amazing, once in the Torah, clearly showing you the connection with the Holy Tongue and the Messiah. But no doubt that this kind of event should not go to pass away, but we should learn from, repent, and realize that we are living in very significant times. So let us see now first what the table says. And this is the following, what we see in the table and what we looked for. So we were looking for, as usually, for best meeting of the words connected. So in Hebrew, Hasufa is a storm. Hasufa is a very strong storm. And the date, 8 of Shinayin-A, 5775. By the way, this, all of it appears in the book of Numbers. Interesting, one book which makes it significant. Also, the Twin Towers came in a few verses in this book of Numbers, and this itself is significant. Then, best meeting of this year, small skip, with the word Asufa, which is the second minimal from 85 appearances of this word in Numbers, which itself is significant. This is minimal. And then we're looking for the day of this month, the date which is the 6th of the month Shvat. The month Shvat, this is now, also comes here minimal, and then we see in English, January, maybe to remind us it's even January, because everything is the Torah. Then, most important, we are Be'arzot HaBrit, in United States, all together we have the storm in the state, Be'arzot HaBrit, in the year 5775. This year and the months here. But the most interesting and the most important is what it's come to teach us. Edom, Achicha Israel. Edom is your brother Israel, and you should look after him. And amazingly, this is what the verse says here in Edom, Ovadia. It was an Edomite convert, and this is what he says about Edom. And this is what the verse says. And that day you stood from afar on the day strangers captured his possessions and foreigners came into the cities, and on Jerusalem they cast lots. You two are like one of them. So this is the Hebrew and this is the English. Amazingly, clearly telling him, Adam, what you should do is, you should, in this day, should not send a fire, but you should help them. The day the strangers captured his possessions, as clearly we see what he's doing today, and foreigners came into his cities, like see all these terrorists coming here, and on Jerusalem they cast lots, exactly these days when they want to put pressure on Netanyahu and Israel to give up Jerusalem, to give pieces of Israel to those strangers, yes, the Arabs who are strangers in this country, in this land which belongs to Israel. Amazingly, exactly this is what is written here, and exactly Edom and Israel, his brothers coming there, and here is a claim against Edom, you should help Israel, not dividing their land, not giving up their land, and who knows, maybe this, what is going on now, is coming to remind them about this situation. So as we said, the table very significant, and reminding Edom, the state, Achicha Israel, Israel is your brother, should help him, giving the whole land, don't definitely divide Jerusalem, and all this, which Obadiah, who himself was converted, Edomite, who really clearly said a lot of things about the future, we can clearly see these days. So, for us, it's just definitely is a clear sign that we have to do Shuvah, to repent, keeping Shabbat, coming back to the rest of the Torah, and realizing that there are more problems that we cannot solve. We cannot solve these kind of problems of storms, earthquakes, tsunamis. What we can solve? Praying, changing our ways, keeping Torah properly, Shabbat properly, morality, purity of life, and then we will not have this terrible situation, which no doubt happening today in this significant year, sabbatical year, before Shvi'ah, no doubt indicates to us that are very, very near to the Messiah. But as the Maimonides says, there is a condition to repent, to believe in God, to keep Torah, to be straight in our ways. Then we'll have really Mashiach coming soon and save us from this problem. It's interesting to point out that the skip is 156, which is the numerical value of Hasufa. So the skip of the letters, Hasufa, 156, is exactly the number 156, which is the numerical value of Hasufa, which is 566, 80 and 5, together 156. Amazingly, another example about the tables of the Torah that are